the next algorithm is least mean square algorithm. So this is the most popular algorithm for adaptive equalizer. So actually the LMS algorithm, as the name suggesting, LMS is nothing but as least mean square. So this algorithm is used to minimize the mean square error. It is MSE, mean square error. Okay, so this equalizer is used to minimize the mean square error between the desired equalizer output and then actual equalizer output. So in the equalizer, we are going to find out the two different types of output. The one is desired output. Desired output is nothing but as expected output, and this one is nothing but as the actual equalizer output. So we are going to find out the least mean square equal to desired equalizer output minus of actual equalizer output. So that is the basic concept. So let us see, we are going to use some different notations for finding the mean square error in a signal. So that notation is somewhat complex, so try to understand carefully. So the adaptive algorithm uses prediction error. So EK is nothing but prediction error to minimize a cost function and updates the equalizer weights in a manner that iteratively reduces the cost function. So let us see, the YK is nothing but as the input signal of the equalizer, that is called as YK. YK can be given as YK, YK minus 1, YK minus 2 up to YK minus N, the whole power transpose. So T is nothing but transpose. The output of the adaptive equalizer in a scalar form, it is given as D cap K equal to summation over N equal to 0 N W N K into Y of K minus N. So this W is nothing but as it denotes the weight vector, and Y is denotes the input signal of the equalizer. So this is the weight vector equation. And here let us see the error signal equation. So the adaptive algorithm is controlled by the error signal when the desired output is known as. So thus DK is nothing but as desired output. So we can be written as DK equal to XK. So DK equal to XK, and the error signal can be given as EK. So here EK equal to desired output minus actual output. So DK equal to DK cap. So it's nothing but as cap. So here DK equal to XK, as I before told that. So EK equal to XK minus D cap K. So this is the final error equation. And coming to next, where XK is the transmitter signal and D cap K, it may be written as this YK transpose into WK. So this I can written as WK transpose into YK. So I'm going to substitute the equation 5 in the previous equation. So XK minus D cap K. So this value I'm going to substitute here. So EK equal to XK minus WK transpose into YK. So, and then we are going to take the mean square error of the above equation, that is 6th equation, to compute the mean square error at time instant K. The equation 6 is squared to obtain modulus of EK the whole square equal to this one. So XK plus Y WK transpose YK, YK transpose WK minus 2XK YK transpose into WK. So, and next step, I am going to take the expected value of the above equation. So, the expected value of modulus of EK square over K is given as, so this one. So, finally, the mean square error can be identified as expectation of EK into EK. So, this EK is nothing but as error signal, and this is also error signal. So, this is your previous error signal, which can be denoted in the asterisk symbol. So, here the LMS algorithm seeks to minimize the mean square error. For a specific channel conditions, the prediction error is dependent on the tap gain vector. So WN is nothing but a tap gain vector. So the MSE of an equalizer is a function of WN. So I'm going to introduce a new component that is called as a cost function. The cost function may be given as J of omega N. So this is the cost function equation. So these equations are something direct equations. So try to memory these equations, because there is no proof for that. And here in this equation, I am going to introduce P is nothing but as cross correlation vector, R is nothing but as input correlation matrix. Let us, and this is the optimum value of the cost function, and this is the corresponding equation. So finally, I am going to update the weight by using the equations. Here D cap K N equal to W N transpose of N into Y N of N, and error equal to X K of N equal to D cap K of N. So this small n denotes the sequence of iterations. This capital N denotes the number of delay stages. So this is the final equation. So the new weight can be calculated by using the previous weight minus constant value into previous error into current input vector. So let us see the advantages of this algorithm, that is LMS algorithm. The first advantage is nothing but as it maximizes the signal to distortion ratio, and there is low computational complexity, and next one is the simple program. The drawbacks of LMS algorithm can be given as slow convergence, and next one is poor tracking. So this very slow to track the channel status. That's all. Thank you.